What's up, guys? Chaos here. Welcome to the COD History Series. Today's video is powered by Red Magic. When they reached out and they wanted to introduce me to the Red Magic 5G, the best gaming phone on the market, well, I said yes. And link at the top of the description if you guys want to go check it out for yourself. 144Hz, 6.65 eSports display. This thing is the epitome of a gaming phone. SA and NSA dual modes means that 5G is supported on all your key regions. Whether you're playing a racing game, PUBG, whatever it may be, this phone, it's got you covered. Now, when you have a phone this intense, you need something just as intense to power it. The Qualcomm Snapdragon 865. And this phone, it has a liquid cooling system. That's right. The phone has a liquid cooling system. Plus, it has adaptive triggers for all of you FPS fans. That's right. And down to a 2 millisecond touch delay on the screen. A few other key features is it has a 64 megapixel Sony triple camera with super night mode on it, which is very cool. And something that's super important for mobile gamers is the battery life. This has up to a 4500 bank, and it can charge your phone from zero to full in 40 minutes. So a high capacity battery is super important for mobile gamers, and being able to charge and refresh super fast is key. You can totally customize the phone, three different color options. I chose the Eclipse. You can customize the LED bar, everything with things. You can make this phone your own. So you guys check it out. Link is at the top of the description. Let me know if you end up getting one, and let's get on to the video. It did kill in 2 to 3 shots, but it also fired at 300 rounds per minute, only 329 with rapid fire. That is a ripoff, meaning that time to kill was going to feel like an eternity. I get told all the time, Jimmy, you don't show enough LMG love on the channel. There's not enough LMG content when it comes to the COD History Series. Well, today we fix that, my friends. Light machine guns are a love them or hate them kind of weapon. Some people associate them with slow handling, campers, but others associate them with area control and long kill streaks. Regardless of what you think of LMGs, let me know what you think in the comments. We can all agree, there's a lot of them in COD history, and there's a lot of them that were kind of bad. What is up, everybody? Chaos here. Today we're going to be going over my picks for the worst LMG in every single Call of Duty from COD 4 all the way up to Modern Warfare 2019. You be sure to let me know in the comments what you think the worst LMG in COD history is, and here we go. Do me a favor, guys, drop a like, and we are starting off with COD 4, the M60 E4. Now, I'm going to give you a spoiler alert. You're going to be seeing quite a bit of the M60 on this list. Now, it was one of the strongest guns in COD 4 in terms of bullet damage, but you almost never saw it on the battlefield because everything else about it was awful. It would hit between 40 and 50 damage, which made it a 2 to 3 shot kill without stopping power, and it would always be a 2-shot kill with stopping power. Sounds good, but that came at a cost. A cost of a low fire rate and a very, very slow handling. Now, it had some bouncy recoil, reload animation that lasts almost 10 minutes. That doesn't go good with Call of Duty games, and perhaps the worst iron sights in COD history. Getting the M60 Gold in Modern Warfare Remastered was a total disaster for most people, and I don't think anybody's going to disagree with me saying it was the worst LMG in the game. World at War. None. There are no LMGs in World at War, so we're just going to move on. Modern Warfare 2. The M240. Now, there weren't really any bad guns in this game, but the M240 was probably the weakest, which is kind of ironic because it's also the last one you unlocked. You had to grind to level 52 to use the M240, and it was probably better just to stick with the RPD or the AUG. And is anybody else with the notion that if it's the last gun, it should be the best gun? Now, it did have a 100 round mag, or a whopping 200 with extended. It also had very low damage, especially for a game as fast-paced as Modern Warfare 2. It dealt a flat 30 damage at all ranges, 20 with a suppressor, and just to add insult to injury, this was one of the guns with the suppressor glitch, where it actually would not hide you from the radar. Now, it did have almost 1,000 round per minute rate of fire, but due to the low damage, tough recoil, and slow handling, it wasn't a great trade-off. It's not a bad gun on its own, but it was outclassed by everything. Now we've reached Black Ops 1, another M60. It probably had one of the best firing sounds in COD history, but you rarely heard it because nobody used it. It would hit for between 50 and 40 damage, 2 to 3 shot kill, but that came at the cost of a super low fire rate, 500 rounds per minute. And I know, you had a 100 round mag, but you also had a very bouncy recoil and terrible, terrible iron sights. And due to the somewhat limited attachment situation in Black Ops 1, there wasn't a lot you could do to buff it up. It was by far the worst LMG in the game, and if you were using an LMG in the game, you're either using the RPK or the Stoner 63. No exceptions. Now we've reached Modern Warfare 3, Round 3, M60E4. Final appearance. It was arguably the worst ever. It featured an identical fire rate to the COD 4 counterpart, but the damage was noticeably nerfed for some reason. It would hit for 50 damage up close, but it decreased down to 35 damage, and that drop-off happened rapidly, meaning you would be killing in 3 shots most of the time. Now, the recoil was the worst. It was the worst. Super bouncy, hard to predict or control. Then go ahead and add on the terrible iron sights and a reload time of 9.3 seconds, and you've got the worst LMG in Modern Warfare 3. Now, LMGs in general suffered in this game. You didn't see them a whole lot on the battlefield, but the M60 was particularly bad. Black Ops 2. Now, on the opposite end of the spectrum, we have this game. A game with pretty amazing LMGs all the way around. We had the MK48, the LSAT, and the Hammer. They all had their own designated roles, but then there was the QBB LSW, the odd man out. This was the second LMG you got your hands on, and it did fire at over 900 rounds per minute, but it had the lowest damage output in the class. It hit for as low as 20 per shot, and there was no headshot bonus. Now, it did reload rather quickly, around 4 seconds, which is good for an LMG, but that didn't make up for it. It wasn't a bad gun on paper, but it was clearly outclassed by every other LMG in Black Ops 2. I mean, come on, you're really going to take the LSW over the Hammer or the LSAT? It's not going to happen. Now we've reached Call of Duty Ghosts. The Ameli. And I've mentioned the Ameli a few times, mainly because it was terrible and everybody forgets it was even in the game. It was the first LMG you got your hands on, and you're probably just going to put it right back down after giving it a go. It hit for 50 damage, which is good, but it dropped very rapidly down to 30, making it a 4-shot kill most of the time while firing at just 631 rounds per minute and handling like a big fat slug. The recoil was high, made it difficult to move around and snap to targets like you could do with the ARs. Ghost had a super quick time to kill overall, so why would you take the Ameli with you? It handled slowly, it fired slowly, and it would take 4 shots to kill most of the time. No. Now we've reached Advanced Warfare, and this is hard because they weren't LMGs. Well, they were heavy weapons, but you had a mixture. You had the EM1, which was a laser weapon. You had the Pytake, you had the XMGs, the EPM3, another laser weapon, and the Ameli. I don't really know which way to go here. I kind of want to go with the 2 fully automatic machine guns in akimbo form and the XMGs. I don't really know which else to go. You could go into lockdown mode and it was good, but it was just super bulky and you were like a huge fat target on the battlefield. I don't know. I'm going to leave this one up to you guys. I want you to help me out. What do you think the worst heavy weapon was in Advanced Warfare? Now we've reached Black Ops 3. I'm going to go with the Gorgon. I remember when people first saw this in the game, the community was talking about it. People were intrigued by this 2-shot kill LMG, but when it actually got a bit of playtime and the meta started developing, people mostly forgot about it. The Gorgon was a very slow firing LMG, 327 rounds per minute. Now, it would hit between 40 and 59 damage, which made it a 2-3-shot kill. Now, it hit like a truck, but it also had extremely slow handling to make up for it. Since Black Ops 3 was a very mobile game, you pretty much had to be camping and holding corners with it in order to make it work in your favor. There was no way you were running out into the battle with the Gorgon. The handling wouldn't allow it. You were slowly moving. It did do an insane damage output for an automatic gun, but the terrible handling and low fire rate made it one of the least used guns in the entire game. Now we've reached Infinite Warfare, and I'm going to go with the Mauler. Now, this was a ridiculous variant that made it shoot multiple bullets at once in a vertical spread pattern, but the base version, it was doo-doo. Unlocked at level 13. It had a very tight hip-fire spread, which was nice, and a very high rate of fire, which was nice. Made it reminiscent of the chain saw from Call of Duty Ghosts, but where it differed, where it fell apart was, well, the damage on the Mauler was very low. It often took 5 shots to kill, and in a game as fast-paced as Infinite Warfare, you were really gonna feel how slow the time to kill was with this thing. Now, certain variants were also nerfed to handle slower, which made it even worse. The high fire rate, it could get you a lot of solid feats in hardcore, but in core, it wasn't very good. It was bad. Now we've reached COD World War II, the Bren. It sucked. It was unlocked very early at level 14, but it was probably one of the least used guns in the game because of how abysmal the handling speeds and the terrible time to kill was. It did kill in 2 to 3 shots, but it also fired at 300 rounds per minute, only 329 with rapid fire. That is a ripoff, meaning that time to kill was going to feel like an eternity. It also had a 30-round mag by default and a very long reload animation to top it all off, the cherry on top of the sundae. It had horrible slow handling speeds. I mean, it was bad. Iron sight sucked. It was just bad all the way around. It was awful. You're not going to change my mind on it. Now we've reached Black Ops 4. The VKM 750. That's right, another super slow firing LMG. It was the slowest automatic gun in BO4, and it's one of the slowest firing guns in COD history. Now, it fired slow, but it did have a high damage output. It killed in 2 to 3 shots, but the handling, that was the problem. It was so slow, it was really tough to use close range, meaning you were pretty much defenseless if someone charged you. Plus, since the gun fired so slowly and the mobility in Black Ops 4 was rather quick, it meant people were often just bob and weave in between your bullets, yeah, and mow you down once they caught where you were. The VKM just wasn't a good weapon. And it seems that every modern COD game has one LMG that fires so slow and hits super hard, but they're never actually any good. And finally, Modern Warfare 2019, the S8A7. Now, choosing the worst LMG in a game like this was actually tough, because they're all good. And you guys know you can kit out pretty much any weapon to function in a number of ways, but if I take a step back and I look at the LMGs, both multiplayer and Warzone, I gotta go with the S8. This gun just doesn't feel like it has a proper place in the sandbox right now. It has a much smaller capacity than the other LMGs, and doesn't handle particularly fast, the recoil isn't friendly, the range isn't great, and overall it seems like it was supposed to be an LMG-AR hybrid, but it doesn't really fit either role very well. Now I know, it can get some work done in hardcore, but ultimately, I think this is the worst LMG in the game. Now could that change because Infinity Ward has been patching things up quite a bit? Yes. Right now, that's what I'm sticking with. And there you have it, my friends. You let me know where you agree or disagree. Drop a like, and I'll see you soon.